Who's ready for a world of magic and wonder? Well, I hope you are, because it's time now for Moose's review of Walt Disney World. That's right, all the magic and all the wonder right here, right now. Now, Disney World is made up of four main parks. You got your MGM, Magic Kingdom, Animal Kingdom, and Epcot. And then there's Typhoon Lagoon and Blizzard Beach, but nobody cares about those. Anyway, we're going to cover all four of the parks that actually matter. But first, why don't we take a look at some of the fine resorts that you could stay at during your time at Disney World. Now, I stayed at All-Star Sports, but there's also All-Star Movies and All-Star Music. But let's face it, they suck! All-Star Sports is the best one, because when you get there, everything is huge! They got giant basketball courts! Oh my god! You can play giant basketball! You can't, they're made of cement or something, but... Giant whistle! Oh my god! And the stairs are inside a giant megaphone! And holy crap, there's a giant tennis ball case of tennis balls. Look out! Hotel Shark! Once inside, you'll find that this is a fairly typical hotel offering, except for all the sports memorabilia lining the walls, and also the fact that the sink is actually outside of the bathroom. I don't really understand the reasoning behind this. Did they think that someone would want to brush their teeth while someone else was taking a shower? I guess it makes sense, but I don't know, we've had sinks in bathrooms for a long time. I just don't see why they felt the need to mix things up. And hey, even Mickey loves Jesus! You know, if you stay in Disney World for 1 week, $2.50 for a Snickers bar actually begins to sound reasonable. Heard the best-kept Disney secret? Well, it can't be that well-kept, because they're advertising it everywhere. Mickey milk? I don't even want to think about what that might be implying. Oh my god, it's giant McDonald's! Oh, where's Mayor McCheese when you need him? And of course they've got these things all over Disney World where you put the penny in and it comes out as a bigger but not usable penny. And I mean, why trade your money in for useless money when you can trade it in for cheap merchandise? Check it out, you got Donald and Piglet and Pluto in various weirdly suggestive poses. And you got Sorcerer Mickey, Talking Sorcerer Mickey, Graduation Mickey, Oven Mitt Mickey, Transvestite Mickey, you got it all! And look at me, I'm just dying to get started, so what do you say we get started?
When you wish upon a star, make no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon...
Turn your pumpkin into a princess, and while you're at it, stop raising such fat, ugly children. Anyway, our first stop is MGM Studios, and located conveniently outside every Disney park and attraction, pornography machines. Stock up now, because you're gonna want that later. Trust me. Is it me, or is it just a little bit conceited to refer to your theme park as our city? Alright, there's a gift shop and we didn't even have to go through the gates yet! Talk about good service! But beware, for Mickey is watching always from atop his globe. He never stops watching. Ha! Look at the fat little Plutos! Fat little Plutos. Lose some weight, fat Pluto. When you first walk in, the main street of MGM just looks like it's bustling with life and excitement. But as you'll soon discover, everything in Disney World is either a ride, a food court, or a gift shop. Everything. Planet Hollywood, a star-studded lineup, everything for the film fan. Hey, that's me! I'm the film fan! Oh, what? They're not playing that new one where Larry the Cable Guy goes to Mexico. Forget it. Behold, the magic of Fantasia, reenacted with plant life. Hey, are they allowed to use those plastic brooms? That seems like cheating to me. Hey, Mickey, what's under your magic hat? A gift shop! Now, I always feel that it's good to have some historical background going into these things, so let's take a little trip through the history of the life of Walt Disney. Walt, for the last time, hands above the waist. The Hitler joke waiting to happen that is this picture is just a little too easy for me. And that's saying something. Okay, somebody has to say it. That Mickey doll looks like crap. Looks like we need some new management down at the Disney sweatshop.
What? I'm drawing on paper with this pen? I don't understand. The lamp and... It's a mouse? I don't know what it is.
Oh my god, how long did it take them to get the image of Mickey Mouse down? It's not very complicated! Shape up! And that's Dancy McGee, a close partner of Walt Disney's in the early days. Hey, it's one of Walt Disney's very first films, Nature's Half Acre. More amazing than Seal Island? I don't know, Seal Island was pretty great. A mouse guitar? Yes, it's true. Back in his day, Mickey was on cheap merchandise everywhere. Thank God they've stopped that kind of garbage now. And here we see Walt Disney explaining to his colleagues the details of top secret Project X. What was Project X, you ask? Why, it was Walt Disney's secret plan to take over the world with robots! Oh, God, it's horrible! Ah, it's going to kill us all! Disneyland? More like Disney Bland, on account of how much it sucks. Aw, don't cry, Mickey. I'm sure we can get the birthmarks removed. No! Square Enix, you stay the hell away from my Disney World! I am not gonna let you ruin all my magic with your chocobos and your mages! Just leave me alone!
I hereby declare Mickey Mouse the ruler of awesome.
And here's all of Walt Disney's Oscars. And not the ones he won, but the ones from the people that he killed and took. Ooh, it's a poster for The Incredibles, only it's in some weird alien language. They got all kinds of crazy stuff like that here at Disney World. Oh, God, stroller stampede! Look out! Look, it's me posing with a poster. Ah, it's cute. Waste, please? Well, you heard the garbage can. Get to wasting! Ah, the Tower of Terror. The scariest ride ever! Believe me, the spookiness of this haunted hotel lobby is only accentuated by the blurry camera angles and poor lighting. Oh, they've got this thing at Disney World where they don't like to actually admit that they work there, so instead of employees only, they have cast members only, or sometimes to fit the theme, prison teleport staff, or some stupid thing like that, and that's one of the many things that you'll just get sick of by the time you're finished with this place. Anyway, they drop you from the elevator, it's terrifying, then you get into the gift shop at the end of the ride, and they sell you Lost DVDs. Wow! That's marketing synergy right there. Another fun ride is the Aerosmith Rockin' Roller Coaster! Woo! Man, giant stuff is always cool, no matter where you go! Paying tribute to Aerosmith are such classic acts as Hannah Montana, Hilary Duff, and the Disney Mania 5, about which I just have absolutely nothing to say. Hey, wow, some really old recording equipment. It's only slightly more advanced than the stuff we use here at MooseTV. Looking for somewhere to eat? Well, look no further than the Sci-Fi Dine-In Theater. Now playing Deliciousness. See, you actually get to sit and watch movie trailers in cars, like a real 50s drive-in movie. What? What's going on? The story, oh my god, it might be true! What do we do? If it's, what is it? A circle? An octagon? A hexagon? Oh no, it's the devil girl from Mars! Oh god, devastation? Ew. Oh no, the most grotesque monstrosity of all! Oh sweet lord, it's breaking loose! It's Rosie O'Donnell! Run! No! God! No! Wow, Death and Desire! That's a movie I gotta see. Hey, there's Larry the Cable Guy! I found him! No, children, don't get too close! He'll get or done you or something! Run! Star Wars? No, this is Disney World, not Lucas World. I have no time for Star Wars. Except for maybe one funny picture of me on a speeder. Go, Ewoks! Oh, I love it. Then you got your Muppet Vision 3D, where Miss Piggy is hailed as a goddess. Power Rangers? Is there anything that Disney does not currently own? Keeping with the park's theme of movies, we come to the Great Movie Ride, a spectacular journey into the movies. Check it out, it's the actual fur coats that they used in the Chronicles of Narnia. Woo! Exciting! Boo! We want Larry the Cable Guy! Get off the screen, you hacks! Gene Kelly? Who are these people? Look at them just dancing in one single frame shot! It's boring! What kind of movies did they make in those days? Okay. Well. Oh, she's smoking. That's a huge turnoff. Oh, my God. He's just singing. I thought he had a gun for a second. And, it's sensational. It's a Broadway ballet. What else is it? Oh, my God, they're gonna kill that man. What am I watching? There's Disney's famous quarter in a tree. If you can pull it out, you got strong fingers. At last we come to the famed Fantasmic Fireworks Water Lights Costume Thing Show Thing. Oh boy, is it something. First, Mickey dances around and makes water appear out of nowhere, and then he fights a giant snake. Oh God, I'm blind! Ow! And then everybody comes out and dances on a boat. Steamboat Willie Mickey is driving the boat, which doesn't make sense to me, because regular Mickey's there, too, which is some kind of weird dimensional paradox. Look, they got every character, even the crappy ones. There's the dwarves, and Aladdin, and... Oh, I hate them all equally. Oh, and then everything just kind of explodes and is on fire. All aboard the SS Friendship! Our adventure is only just begun.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream.
Inferior guests with your bags, watch as I zoom past you in the bag-free lane. Well, here we are in Magic Kingdom, as you can see by its famous landmark, Cinderella's Castle. Gosh, isn't she beautiful? I just can't wait to check her out. Really, the thing is very big and shiny and magical and fairy-like, and you can see how much I'm enjoying myself. But let's go inside and find what magic awaits us there. Ooh, pretty pictures. Neat, there are fairies and castles and horses. And oh, I just feel like a little girl again. And then you go in a little more and, oh my God, it's another gift shop. Well, at least this one's a little classier than most. Everything seems to be very fragile in here, which makes me sort of nervous. Stupid patriotic Mickey loves America so much.
do we all. As do we all.
Why is Virtual Magic Kingdom playing? I am in the real Magic Kingdom. What is their logic behind this?
We start things off with the boring part of Magic Kingdom, the Hall of Presidents. Who's ready to get educated about America? I am. I am. The Great Seal of the United States sure is awesome because it's got an eagle on it, but they don't let you step on it because apparently that's against the Constitution or something. And that's a painting of George Washington declaring war on the entire rest of the world. That war wages on to this very day. Hey, neat presidential souvenirs! I'm just going to assume that that's Bill Clinton's saxophone, and over there is George Bush Sr.'s helmet, which Barbara made him wear 24/7. And that's a model for a George W. Bush animatronic that they actually had give a speech in the Hall of Presidents. It's kind of creepy, so if I were you, I'd skip out. I do solemnly swear that I will faithfully execute the office of the President of the United States and will, to the best of my ability, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States. So help me God! That should be in there! I find that disrespectful. Boy, I'm feeling patriotic, so I'm gonna ring the Liberty Bell! Ding, 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 ding! Ha, ha, ha. Liberty. Alright, Splash Mountain is my absolute favorite ride at Disney World. I can't wait to go on it! Look, there's Brer Fox and Brer Bear, who just barely avoid being horrible negative racial stereotypes. For your safety, please do not get up and dance during any portion of the ride. You may get wet. Oh, forget that. I'm not going on this ride. Let's find something else to do in this fun little town, shall we? Hey, it's a cigar store Indian. Except it's a Native American, you racist. Wow, tea like from the Boston Tea Party. I feel so thirsty. All right, who wants to go on the Big Thunder Mountain Railroad? Be careful, there's dynamite. Yeah, let's skip it. But I might have to take that train, because I'm on the run from the law. Oh, my God, they got me in those stings there. Good. Uh-oh, looks like we're entering the somewhat seedier part of town. And that means... Well, it doesn't really mean anything, but what do you say we go on Pirates of the Caribbean next? Man, this ride is cool. It just makes me want to go out and buy all the Pirates DVDs that are on sale now at a store near you. Yo-ho, yo-ho! Pirates life for... Woo, pirates! A whole barrel of rum really helps the employees get through the day. Hey, look, a real puffy shirt, just like real pirates wear. I don't want to be a pirate. But this guy does. He's an actual Johnny Depp replica, created in a top-secret illegal factory at Disney World. Very convincing, and good for the kids. And look who else decided he wanted to be a pirate after all. That is so sad. Hey, what's that in the distance? Does it look scary? Well, it should, because it's Disney's Haunted Mansion, where the ghosts are so smart, they actually decided to rent their mansion out to tourists. Oh my God, it's a carriage being pulled by invisible horses! Except it's in a fenced-off area, so it kind of looks like it's just parked there temporarily. Here lies good old Fred. A great big rock fell on his head. Rhyming tombstones! Dear departed brother Dave, he chased a bear into a cave. And I assume that the bear killed him. In memory of our patriarch, dear departed Grandpa Mark. they loved their, that one's not really that funny. Hey, I see Tomorrowland in our future. You see, because Tomorrowland is a land about the future, so by saying that it's in our future, it creates a whole set of ironies that I don't even want to go into.
This is Stitch's Great Escape, which used to have a really scary alien before they decided to replace it with Stitch from Lilo and Stitch and completely ruin the ride. So here you go on the prison teleport center, and then a robot talks to you, and then I sort of lost interest. Of course, if you're looking for thrills and chills, then Space Mountain's your game. Ooh, fuzzy star charts. What does it mean? And more robots! Oh, the future's full of them. And now we arrive at Star Command Headquarters for Buzz Lightyear's Space Ranger Spin. Uh-oh, robot attack! Oh, God, the robots! We should have known not to trust them! And Buzz Lightyear's right there to guide you along, all shiny and welcoming and repeating the same things over and over. And then you can see his ugly, malformed friends and his friends who sit behind bars. All right, the Carousel of Progress puts you on a revolving stage where you get to watch the poorly developed characters of a family experiencing new technologies as they arise. Fascinating! I waited in this line for about 20 minutes before I realized it was for autographs from Buzz Lightyear. And that sort of just turned me off the whole thing. Country Bear Jamboree? That doesn't sound very future-y at all. In fact, it's horrifying. Oh, what are they? Ah! Child under 7 must be accompanied by an adult? Are you saying that an 8-year-old kid can roam Disney World just by himself? What kind of crazy laws are they running down here in Orlando? Oh, God. Oh! Oh! The more I see, the less I want to. All right, this is horrible. This is a sin against both man and bear kind. And what's with that little one just sitting in the log in the corner? She looks terrified, like they're holding her there against her will. Ugh. Oh, God, and then they all come out and sing, and ew. Oh, some of them are babies, and oh, God, it's coming out of the ceiling. Oh, ew. Oh, oh. Ew. Tea party, that always cools me down. 'Cause it's so mad! Oh, the madness! Look at them spin! Oh, the madness is maddening! And hey, get out of there! Oh, that just ruins the whole experience. Hey, I went on that ride. They aren't that scary. Hey, I went on that one too. There aren't even that many. Pooh's Thoughtful Shop? This bear is a role model for children, and you're teaching them to spell thoughtful so, so wrong. Peter Pan's Flight, Mrs. Potts' Cupboard, everything in this park is for somebody else. Where's my ride? Pooh's Playful Spot is intended for the enjoyment of children ages 2 to 5 years old. Supervise children at all times. Mickey's Philhar Magic. Or as I like to call it, Mickey's Philhar Boring as Hell. Ah, well, at least nothing's as bad as Country Bear Jamboree. No, 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 please, please don't make me go on that. I'll do anything. I'll puke if I go on that ride. I will die. I will die.
Let's just go to Mickey's Toontown Fair and try and have a good time. Mickey's semi-nemesis Pete finally gives up his life of harassing our mousy friend and starts a garage. And then he encourages children to drink gasoline. Hang on, a garage and a paint shop in the same town? That's gotta be some kind of a violation. And this, I believe, is the entrance to Goofy's 9/11 remembrance ride. What? I hear it's very tasteful. Oh, look across the street! It's Minnie's house! Oh, let's go inside! Her mailbox is modeled after her own face! Just a little bit conceited, but who cares? And there's Minnie's early family back in the 1800s. And that's a picture of Minnie doing something. Everything in Minnie's house is colorful and cute. Even the ugly children who sit on her couches. Oh, of course she wins the grand prize for all of her garbage. And why is Donald always so angry? Up, another grand prize for a blanket of hearts and Mickey shapes. Brilliant. And there's a hilarious picture with Disney things. And, oh, books with puns on the spines. I can't get enough. And that's Minnie showing just how incredibly conceited she truly is by drawing her own self-portrait and then having someone paint a picture of that and putting it in her house. Oh, but you should keep Clarabelle the cow out of it. Oh boy, another grand prize for a picture she painted of herself! I hate Minnie! Things to do today. Call Mickey. Make a box lunch for Mickey. Tend to the garden. Make a cake for Mickey. Minnie is the worst female role model of all time. All hail the corn god! Hey, the Toontown Farmer's Market, full of fresh produce and... I'm just kidding, it's a gift shop. Alright, Mickey's house! I'm really excited now! Okay, there is a fine line between cute and disgusting, and they have crossed it! Oh my god, on his fence post? I mean... And he's got a little statue of himself on his table? I can't believe this guy! Even his checkers pieces are shaped like his own head! Why does everyone hate Donald so much? At least he doesn't model his entire house after his own face. Oh, and the ping pong... Oh, God. And the kitchen's a mess. See, that's why you let Minnie take care of that kind of thing. Alright, enough messing around. I came here to meet Mickey, and if the judge's tent is where I gotta go, then that's where I'm gonna go. Hey, where's Pluto? He's not at his house. If you see Pluto, please tell him to take himself for a walk. What, Mickey has to leave notes for other people to take care of his dog for him? How irresponsible can he be?
Oh boy, my garden sure looks swell. Maybe even wear blue ribbon.
Oh, the tomatoes and the pumpkin and... how can anyone like Mickey after walking through this place? Whoa, hold on. Mickey is the judge? This whole thing is a sham. It's rigged. I can't believe this. Anyway, you stand in line for about 45 minutes and wonder what that thing on the wall is. It looks like a cow-chicken hybrid. But at least they keep you entertained with little movies now and then. Oh, they're a lot more violent than I remember, you know? Finally, I got to meet Mickey Mouse! Sure, it was uncomfortable, but you know what? It was worth it. I have spent way too much time in this part of the park already, so let's please move along.
When you wish upon a star, make no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream.
All right, here we are at Animal Kingdom. This one's kind of like a big zoo, except with
Disney gift shops all over the place. Oh, ah, the Tree of Life. The Tree of Life has all these animals carved into it, and it's amazing and also ironic because it's made of cement. The one on the right is for recycling, and the one on the left is for trees. Ooh, don't you just feel like you're in a rainforest? Wow, a bird! I'm gonna name him Birdface. Oh my god, it's a giant Galapagos tortoise! Ah, no, false alarm, it's just boring size. Crazy gibbons jumping around in the, what looks like telephone wires. Anyway, they're crazy. Hark, lurking in the distance, it's the snowy Himalayans. This place is like a biodome. It's got everything you could want from an animal kingdom. And now we embark on Expedition Everest, where a yeti attacks you. You must be 1 yeti foot tall to ride. Well, that's not really fair, because some yetis might have bigger feet than others, and how can you really say that, you know, bear? Why, yes. Yes, that is a bear. Aw, the yeti's cute and cuddly. Let's leave. All aboard the Wildlife Express! Hey, look, free luggage! Take it! Wild animal poaching is a social evil. Oh, it's not that bad. Sometimes they just deserve to die. Especially the endangered ones. I figure finish them off quick. It's better for everybody. Hey, I didn't know Monkey signed a merchandise deal with Disney. Good for him. Giant flying ladybugs! Pete Safari! Oh, very clever. Alright, the Rainforest Cafe is, of course, the quintessential eating experience at Animal Kingdom. And they've got wild gators loose outside and... Uh-oh, that guy's gonna get sprayed by an elephant! Ah, what a jerk. Everything in the Rainforest Cafe is authentic, which means those are real giraffe legs that they carved off of them. But don't worry, they're keeping them alive in a horrible, painful sort of giraffe half-life tunnel thing. Then you got your cool stuff like fish and elephants and the gift shop. Oh, the merchandise is even worse here than inside the park. Ah, and that tree, it watches you and talks to you and it creeps me out. The scenery sure is nice here. It's just like I'm in a quaint little pseudo-African village of some sort. Oh, that's because I'm in Africa. Owl. Oh my god, the garbage cans are finally rebelling! Run, everyone, run! And hey, look, some flamingos. Now, you can pick any one of those, and they will take it out and cook it for you. Highly recommended. Okay, here's the good stuff. Dino Land. Man, dinosaurs are awesome. There's no arguing with that, so this is clearly the best part of Animal Kingdom. Petrifries! I immediately regret my decision to come here. Behold, real, fake imported dino bones. Dino-rama! That's probably a velociraptor, and if it could talk, it would probably go, rah! And if that dinosaur could talk, it would go, oh god, help me, I have no skin or internal organs! Oh, it burns! Someone kill me! Now this ride's a thrilling trip back in time, aptly titled Dinosaur, sponsored by a generous grant from McDonald's. Well, that explains the McNuggetosaurus out front. What, is that dinosaur stupid? There's meteors coming right at it! Oh yeah, he looks pretty stupid. Wow, real fossils and a centipede. That is not a dinosaur. Get that out of here. Neither is a giant water beetle a dinosaur. That's a mammal up There it is, Da Vinci's masterpiece. Dinosaurs running from flaming rocks out of space.
Not many people know about that one.
Rawr, I'm T-Rex, I'm so scary.
Get some skin, then we'll talk. Oh, God, just when you thought the puns couldn't get any worse. Faculty and grad students only, Osaurus? Okay, they're not even trying. I paid good money to hear good puns. This is a disgrace. Can you do the can? Oh, now there's T-Rex. Roar! Hey, wake up. Come on, do something. Ah, this is boring. No! Okay, this is really the main draw of Animal Kingdom. It's this animal safari where you get to go on a little car and take pictures of wild animals in their fake natural habitats. Gosh, it's just so serene and peaceful out here in the open all on your own with no one but nature and the other cars to disturb you. And here's your little handy-dandy animal checklist. Just in case you get confused, look back here and figure out exactly what it is you're looking at. Oh, look, I think those are storks. Or probably storks. The camera's a little shaky, sorry about that, but... over here we have, some hippos and a bird standing on top of them. You dumb hippos. Oh, boy. Oh, gators! Gators! Come on! Oh, look, a giraffe! I can see you. God, it's hard to get a good shot of these things, so I'm sorry. Okay, I think those are yaks. That's something. Oh, and I gotta look back at the chart, but those are probably gazelles or, I don't know, lions, maybe. The scenery is just kinda nice over here. Very hard to get a good shot. Oh, elephants! Turn around! Come on! Please? Oh, God! Ah! What a waste of time! Stop taunting me! Ostrich! Finally! Oh, yeah! Love him! Love him! It's not an emu. Is there a difference? Do I care? Oh, and zebras and oh, God. I can't get enough of animals. Okay, so I'm sorry there's not a whole lot to see in Animal Kingdom, and, it's really hard to get decent shots of animals if you're me and inept when it comes to photographs, but hey, it's the newest park, so what can you expect? We got one more! Let's finish this!
When you wish upon a star, make no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme.
And we arrive at last at Epcot, also known as the crappy one. This here is an up-close and personal look at the famous Epcot Sphere, also known as Spaceship Earth, which is a boring ride that you can sleep through if you're tired. Out front, you've got these walls of faces. It's sort of like Ellis Island, except people's faces, and they're not immigrants, they're rich white guys.
Welcome to Club Cool, home of Coca-Cola! Come on inside and you can try flavors around the world. Woo!
Oh, I think this is from Israel, and... Oh, I say good show, Israel.
Yes, here is Imagination! A fun-filled imagination ride that encourages kids to use their imagination! And up in the corner there is Figment, the annoying purple dragon who you will hate immediately.
Journey into Imagination with Figment! Woo! The Inventor of the Year Award recipients! There's Rick Moranis, Robin Williams, and, oh, Eric Idle. Ah, didn't you have anything better to do? Hey, that rainbow can only mean one thing. It's the universe of energy. That's right, this ride is actually hosted by Bill Nye the Science Guy and popular talk show host Ellen DeGeneres to teach you all about different forms of energy. And you know what would be great? If they had a sitcom together, because the chemistry, mwah, it's there. Ah, everything in this park is alive! It's scary. Okay, kids, who wants your picture taken with the shapeless rock formation? Oh, I do! Woo, planets! That's right, it's Mission Space, where they spin you around really, really, really fast to simulate the feeling of going to Mars in a rocket ship. In fact, it's so intense that they have to let you know there's an intense version and a lame version. I did the intense version, and it was still lame. But what are you gonna do? If possible, I hate Hippie Mickey even more than regular Mickey. Oh, I think this is Test Track, where they put you in a car like a crash test dummy. And on the way in, you see all these weird experiments with cars and how they're built and stuff. So far, I don't think the laptops using steering wheels thing is working out. The doorless and seatless car was also a short run. Now, personally, I find it offensive that the crash test dummies are all naked, and I think it's also a little offensive that that one seems to be hanging itself. Hang on, the little baby dummy gets to wear pants, but not the pregnant one? That seems a little unfair to me. Oh, look! I found Nemo! Wait, where'd he go? I lost... there he is, swimming! Woo! Go, Nemo, go! Oh, watery fish. And this is the only halfway decent attraction at Epcot, the World Showcase, where you get to experience a little bit of every country in the world that matters. Let's start with England! Pip, pip, cheerio, mate! Oh, English accents are humorous. Famous fish and chips! Except they're fries, not chips, because English people are mentally challenged. Check it out, it's like a regular English phone booth. Hello? England? Yeah, your phone booths are too red. I don't like them. New from England. Tea. It's coffee for boring people. Oh, that's right, Mary Poppins is British. Neat. And then there's a bad Beatles knockoff band. Okay, they sound exactly like the Beatles. I can't really complain about them. And this is actually colonial America, but it's still pretty British, so I might as well lump it in here. Hey, that guy should not be in line. Oh, I'm not sure I feel totally comfortable here, but, well, I'll just stop in for a second. It couldn't hurt. Beer! Yay! Ugh, those things are creeping me out. Ah! Stop staring at me! Canada, are you serious? Do we really need two of those in the world? Hey, French and Canada, the two things I hate most in the world. A totem pole? What part of Canada is this? No, that's not Mexico. That's one of Disney World's cleaning staff. Off in the distance, you'll see France and, I don't know, Mongolia or something. You get a great view from up here of the trees and, oh my god, what's that? Oh god, giant bird attack! Ah! It wreaks havoc from atop its spooky rock! Flee! Flee! Alright, China, home of scary lions! Ah! Don't eat me! And this is the interior of an actual Chinese temple that was brought overseas on a giant boat from China to Orlando. That ancient gold relic depicts an epic battle between some fuzzy dragonish gold things.
Check it out. It's the tombs of 1,000 dead soldiers. Well, it's a miniature replica of the tombs of 1,000 dead soldiers. And I plan to revive them all and use them to conquer the globe. Cool. And hey, the last country worth noting, in my opinion, home to otakus and fanboys everywhere, Japan. Look at the little Japan fish. Oh, they're so cute. Sushi. Of course, Japanese food isn't the only thing here in Japan. You've got plenty of other horrible, weird stuff to gawk at while you're here. Like Pokemon, Transformers, Eris Dies, Speed Racer. Oh, what are those? Ew, they're creepy. Manchichi? Ew, they've got little outfits for them and everything. Oh, got it. Chicken suit. Why would they do that? Oh, creepy. Japan is scary as hell, so let's escape back to our real world of fake Disney merchandise, shall we? These little things are everywhere. They're little squeezy fan water sprayers. And they're great because they're expensive and it's really hot and you're gonna get desperate and you are going to buy one. Of course you can't leave Disney World without a mouse ears hat. They've got varieties of all kinds. You got your standard traditional Mickey hat, the purple Tinkerbell hat, of course pirate hats to capitalize off the movies, my first ear hat. Like, this is something they're going to be proud of later on in life when they have a collection of ear hats to themselves. I just don't see that. Oh, and pins! You can't forget all the money you're going to waste on stupid, worthless pins. Oh my god, there are so many of these things. They are everywhere! 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 Pirates and chipmunks and Eeyore encrusted with diamonds? What is this? Okay, I think we can effectively wrap up Epcot with a spectacular fireworks show that incorporates all the countries. Is anything happening? It's dark. Oh, I see it now. There go the fireworks. I think that's an explosion. I actually do not know if that was supposed to happen or not. Ah, more fire and woo! It's like I'm watching magic happening. I'm just feeling tingly all through my insides. Oh, and then the globe comes out, and that's just beautiful because it's floating around on the water and reminding us that we are forced to live on a planet with other human beings. And, wow, I mean, it's very pretty. And then the world splits open and there's a fire inside of it, which probably represents the turmoil that will eventually engulf us all in a giant world war. But right now, it's just kind of fun to look at the pretty fireworks. There's nothing quite like fireworks to wrap up Epcot. I don't know.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme.
Buddy, pal of mine, thanks for the memories. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of my trip to Disney World, shall we? Look, that's me with Chip. No, wait, it's Dale. You can tell because, Dale's the stupid one. And there's Mooshu. Next to Pluto Nash, that was perhaps Eddie Murphy's finest role. Brer Bear and Brer Fox! Let me tell you have no idea how fuzzy those guys are.
I just wanted to hug him forever.
To infinity and beyond!
I forget the name of that one.
Oh, and there's me with Herbie, the famous car that's sort of alive. I look just like Lindsay Lohan. Pre-cocaine and anorexia Lindsay Lohan.
There you go.
Anyway, just remember, Disney World wasn't really started by a man. It was started by a mouse. So thank you, Mickey. Thank you for the magic. But I need to go home now. Disney World, you lovable scamp, I am giving you a final score, my highest recommendation, a full 12 out of 12. Because come on, it's freaking Disney World. It's filled with magic and wonder, and you're a kid again, and there's dinosaurs and lava and dancing and fireworks and characters and outer space and... Go right now, go online, get a plane ticket and a hotel reservation, spend a week in Disney World. I guarantee you, it will be the happiest time of your whole life. I'm Moose, and I love Mickey Mouse, so thanks for watching. I know it was long, but you're brave. Goodbye.